ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. ونشهد أن سيدنا وقديرنا ومولانا محمدا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب. صدق الله وصدق رسوله الكريم. Distinguished ulama, dear respected students of Quran and Sunnah, first of all, I would like to pay thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who provided me specially this ample and golden opportunity to see the ulama and the tulaba of deen here in a madrasa and darul ulum. Back home, my dear respected brothers, in Bangladesh, India, Pakistan, or other Islamic countries, lot of madaris are there, but here in the Western and developed world, having a madrasa like this, that is a ghanima blessing in the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear respected brothers in Islam, sometimes I say that all tulaba of ulum-e-diniya, they are awliya in a sense. Means they have disconnected themselves from worldly attachment and worldly affairs, devoted themselves to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that what zuhud is, what taqwa is, and what walaya is. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith, وَإِنَّ الْمَلَائِكَةَ لَتَزَغُ أَجْنِحَتَهَا رِزًا لِذَالِبِ الْعِلْمِ. To please and make happy a talib of ilmihi, the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are unfolding their wings to them. So it means that angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are saluting to the tulaba of ulum diniya. So say alhamdulillah. Little bit loud. Jazakumullah. My dear respected brothers, I have recited an ayah of Holy Quran. قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. In certain ayat and surahs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started with the kalima of قُلْ, which is صِيغَةُ الْأَمْرِ from قَالَ يَقُولُ, And full literal meaning is said based on Exodus, Usul of Tafsir, our methodology of Tafsir. Our Mashayikh told us that Quran as a whole is muballagh. Ya ayyuha Rasul, balligh ma unzila ilayk. Whatever you have received from Allah, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down to you, O my Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, balligh, convey it. فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلْ فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَتَا. If you will not do that, so it means that that is a deficit in Risala. You have not conveyed the message properly. And as you know, that the best message of a Rasul is Inzar. هَذَا نَزِيرٌ مِنَ النُّذُورِ الْأُولَى. Even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ahzab, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا. Other titles and qualities of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one of these is mentioned Mubashir, and the second one is Nazir. But basically, a messenger is sent for Inzar. When the area concerned, they was full of filth. When the people are majority of them, they turn to evil. They were the followers of Satan. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them a nazir. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَذَّبَ الثَّمُودُ بِالنُّذُرِ. Even those who zur, that is Siratul Jama, are plural. And basically that is the plural and Jama of nazir. So ulama say, the takzeeb of one nazir is the takzeeb of all nuzur. Because message is one and the same. When some people, they made objection to the message of a messenger, مَا سَمَعْنَا بِهَذَا فِي مِلَّةِ الْآخِرَةِ إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا اخْتِلَافِ. That the message this messenger is giving, we have never heard it in history. مَا سَمَعْنَا بِهَذَا فِي مِلَّةِ الْآخِرَةِ. And any other deen or regarding any other deen, we have not heard about this message. That there is no deity to be worshipped but only one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said that no, these people are telling lies. These people are playing games with history. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ. We have not sent before you any messenger, but his message was أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ. That there is no deity to be worshipped, but only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it means that that is a universal phenomena. That's a global phenomena. Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, it was parted with him. It processed through Noah alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, perfected and completed with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. شَرَعَ لَكُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا وَصَّى بِهِ نُوحًا وَالَّذِي أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ وَمَا وَصَّيْنَا بِهِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى وَعِيسَى أَنْ أَقِيمُوا الدِّينِ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ كَبُرَ عَلَى الْمُشْرِكِينَ مَا تَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَيْهِ اللَّهُ يَجْتَبِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يُرِيدُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we have given you the same deen which we had given to Noah alayhi salatu wasalam, and the deen which we had given to Ibrahim, to Musa, to Isa عليهم الصلوات والتسليمات. حضرت الإمام الشهر بن الله رحمة الله عليه, he says إن أصل الدين واحد والشرائع مختلفة. If أصل الدين is one and the same, what was the دعوة in the motto of Adam? لا إله إلا الله. What was the motto of Nuh عليه السلام? لا إله إلا الله. إبراهيم موسى عيسى لا إله إلا الله. هود صالح شعيب عليهم الصلوات والتسليمات لا إله إلا الله. إذ الله سيد لقد أرسلنا نوحا إلى قومه فقال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره وإلى عاد أخاهم هودا فقال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره وإلى ثمود أخاهم صالحا فقال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره وإلى مدين أخاهم شعيبا فقال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره. أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال He said the same thing يا أيها الناس كونوا لا إله إلا الله. So deen is one and the same. Yes, شرائع or أحكام differed from time to time. Imam Khaliullah said unto Allah عليه Allah the sole creator He was knowing the nature of people of every area in the nature of people of every time. So He was giving them شرائع in accordance with the circumstances they were living here in and accordance the nature they were having it. My dear respected brother, my respected students. So هذا نذير من النذر الأولى. Hey. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He ordered Musa and Harun عليهم الصلوات والتسليمات that is هبا إلى فرعون. If you both may go to Pharaoh and to his people in the Utahat, he has transgressed the boundaries. He has violated all the boundaries, Sarahada. He has violated all the limits. He has become a rebellious. He has become a tawhi. Izhab ila fir'auna innahu tawha. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ أَوْ يَخْشَى. When you will go there, so talk to him very nicely. قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا in a soft word. Because you know, if you are talking to someone in harsh tone, it offends you. And then he showed a reaction. فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا. Yes, that is something else. That you will be giving him tarheeb and tarheeb both. Tarheeb and tarheeb both. فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيِّنًا لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُ أَوْ يَخْشَى. فالتذكر هو أن يؤمنوا رغبة والخشية أن يؤمنوا رهبة. ابن عباس رضي الله عنه لعله يتذكر فيؤمنوا رغبة أو يخشى فيؤمنوا رهبة. People accept an idea either because of some affection or because of some fear. إذ الله سبحانه وتعالى الآية of Surah Shura which I recited before that أن أقيم الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه كبر على المشركين ما تدعوهم إليه أنه يجتبي إليه من يشاء and they take اجتباء يجتبي إليه. He is pulling towards him. He is attracting towards him. So attraction is based on رغبة. Based on ترغيب. الله يجتبي إليه من يشاء ويهدي إليه من يريد. And in a book is based on ترغيب. لعله يتذكر أو يخشى. So dear students and my respected brothers, I was referring to that every messenger was sent when the area was full of evils, full of satanas, and full of shayateen. That's why every messenger is called Nazir. هَذَا نَذِيرٌ مِنَ الْنُذُرِ الْأُولَى. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sent in such like situation. The peninsula, that was in very bad situation. You have studied, or you heard from your ulama and your asatiza and mashayikh, that how the environment was at that time رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم he was sent to الجزيرة العربية and to Peninsula. If you know that not only there, that their عقيدة was there, not only there, that their اعتقاد was their actions were dirty as well. The actions were filthy as well, making partners with Allah سبحانه وتعالى. That is the case of عقيدة. الإمام ولي الله رحمة الله عليه, he said that shirk is actually or basically of two types. One, he titles it as shirk al-tashbih, and the second one, al-ishraq. So as far as tashbih is concerned, resemblance. So as far as tashbih is concerned, so it means they thinking of Allah, considering him like a creature. So let's start with the tashbih. And ishraq means thinking of a creature the like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Giving a creature the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Imam Rahmatullahi alayhi said, yes, these two types of shirk is the history of the human. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he came, he found the people of Arabia that they were busy in both types of shirk, in ishraq and in tashbih both. So he said, Ya ayyuhan nas, Qulu, La ilaha illallah. Say, there is no deity to be worshipped. There is no ilah. Now the word ilah, the ulama say that that is actually from walahaya. One point of view. وَمِنْهُ الْوَلْهَانِ بِالْحَدُ مِنَ الشَّيَاطِينِ. والهان, for one shaitan, that is the title of the Ibn Kathir rahmatullahi alayhi narrated a hadith. My dear respected brothers, so walahaya alahu, it means tahayyur. Walhan is there certain who is causing you a confusion, especially when you are making wudu. So you start walhan because you are getting confused. Whether I wash my mouth or not, whether I wash three times or four times or one time. So he start walhan. So if ilaha is from walahaya yawlahu, and actually it was milah, the kasr al-waw. So it means the entity, the hukul are mutahayyir and confused in their entity. Ebarqaras qiyalu qiyasu gumanu wahma. Wazhati guftaan nashuni de mukhwan da'in. Daftar tamam gashtu babaya rasida umr ma hamchuni dar awwali wasri guman da'in. Because marifat ilahi or marifatullah, there is such a subject where there is no graduation. There is no dastar bandi. There is no certificate in this regard. وَعَبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَعْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. This text or nisab is going until your last moment. Until your last breath. Because nobody can say that I have known Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completely and perfectly. How? You are making the entity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mahdood. Now, even though that so many books from the south have been taken out. In our time, Mawlana Sahib is sitting here. Mawlana Abdullah Sahib is sitting here. So, in our time, the Nisab was a comprehensive Nisab. There is one book, and that is called Sunnah al-Ulum of Mawlana Bihari. So, here regarding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has said a sentence, La yuhadd. The entity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could not be limitized. That is one meaning, literally. Words wise meaning. But la yuhaddu, technical meaning is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could not be defined as far as mahiyah is concerned. Like as you know, that when we define human, so we say al-insanu haywanun natun. Al-insanu haywanun. Natif. So Hewan is its genus, and Natif is its person. In genus, he has commonality with other Hewanah, with other animals, but in Nutub. And what is Nutub? Jazakallah. This Nutub is not in the meaning of uttering words that he is speaking. And God sometimes embarrasses him, even though he does not know that what he says. That is not the words of him. Say, he imitates. So that is imitation. He doesn't know that what he means. It is said that one nice guy, kind-hearted guy, he came to a garden. So he saw the parents here, that the garden people, they have put a tray for them. So the parents were coming, they were sitting on their tray and swinging. Yes, and the tray was taken there. So many of them, they were. So this kind-hearted guy, he said, oh, this is very beautiful to these poor boys. Let me teach them that something. Because they can learn the words and they can imitate the word. So let me teach them. So in Urdu, he taught them. They have bar to a very permanent. Or if you're waiting, you will never sit on the bamboo of this garden. Or if you're waiting, and if you will look, you will not swing. Yes, you will have a direct flight like that of helicopter. Not to get fed. Yes, so when they were repeating these sentences, they have bound to a null for me that in the or if they're waiting here, the purple mark or old language. Got it? So he said, inshallah, no one will get trapped on this mela or this bamboo. Tomorrow, once again, we began. So a few of them, they were trapped here. And still they were saying, ke baap ke nal par nahi baithenge, aur agar baithenge, to par par pada kar ul jayenge. So he said, well, this stupidity and foolishness this is. That they are saying the word, but they are not doing what it means, because they were not doing what it means is. And that's why sometimes I say, that if somebody, he learned a lot, he is not practicing it like those guys. Ke baap ke nal par nahi baithenge, aur agar baithenge, to par par pada kar ul jayenge. Qazi Abu Yusuf rahmatullahi alayhi, you know Qazi Abu Yusuf? You don't know? Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Qazi Abu Yusuf is our Imam. The student of Imam Abu Hanifa, rahmatullahi alayhi, the compiler of Nawadir. As you know, the compiler of Zawahir is who? No. Imam Muhammad, yes. The compiler of Zawahir is Imam Muhammad ibn Hassan al-Shaybani, rahimahullah. The compiler of Nawadir is, and then these great ulama, they are teaching us that regarding ibadah or other issues, we have to go by the opinion of Imam Muhammad Hassan, rahmatullahi alayhi. But regarding qaza and court issues, we have to go by the opinion of Qazi Abu Yusuf, that you are judge, and not only judge. You know the judge. Yes or not? Of the Supreme Court, High Court, and Supreme Court. But there is a head judge who is called what? No, in English.
Chief
Justice. Chief Justice. Chief Justice of High Court, or Chief Justice of Supreme Court. Before Abu Yusuf, this title was not known anywhere all over the world. He is the first one in human history who was titled as a Chief Justice. Or Qazi al-Qaza. Otherwise, before him, all the Qaza they were Qazi. All the justices they were justices. Everybody was titled as justice. But when Abu Yusuf, rahmatullah alayh, he accepted the Qaza in the time of which Khalifa? Yes, Allah. This is the barakah and karama of Darul. If you are sitting in front of ulama, Khalifa Harun Rashid. So, Qazi Abu Yusuf rahmatullahi alayh, he put a condition before his appointment. And that condition was, the judiciary must be separated from executive. Done? As you know, the government everywhere that is consists of the three branches. How many branches? Three. Number one, Al-Muqannina. The legislative body, like our Congress or Senate, including the President as well. Because in such like system as we are living here, and maybe in Bangladesh, or in Pakistan, or in India, there are two houses. One is called the House of Commons, the other one is called the House of Lords in Britain. But in India, that is called Lok Sabha and Rajya. الصباح. In Pakistan, they started National Assembly and Senate. And here, they call it Congress and Senate. So as you know, that these both houses, they frame a law, they formulate a law, they accept a law for final death that is done to the president. And then the president sign it, so they become an act and that is an implemented law. There's a canon. Nobody has any right to violate that canon. You know what I'm saying? So before Qadi Yusuf, the Khalifa, he was the head of the legislature, he was the head of the Intizamiya executive, and he was the head of judiciary as well. Al-Mukannina, wal-Intizamiya, wal-Adliya. So Qadi Yusuf, rahmatullahi alayh, we are thankful to Qadi Yusuf. Otherwise, the judges were supposed to ask Mr. Joe Biden, what should I decide? How can I be free? But now the judges, they are free in accordance with law to decree accordingly. The president like it or the president doesn't like it. They have the right to interpret the constitution. The president or the governor like it or he doesn't like it. Even though in third world countries, they are looking towards. Yes, practically they are looking towards. Hey, what will make the governor happy? What will make the chief minister happy? What will make the president happy or the prime minister happy? But where law is the supreme, constitution is the supreme, so they are not looking towards the executives, the governors, or the chief minister, or the president, or the prime ministers. So anyhow, my dear sister, actually, this was the quality of Islam, but unfortunately, we have made a mess of this thing. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Otherwise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَنْ أَقِيمُ الدِّينِ. Say loudly. No, not like this. This is the same Quran you are reciting here. I have not brought any new Quran from the book here. أَنْ أَقِيمُ الدِّينِ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. What is تَفَرُّقُ بِالدِّينِ? Most of the Fusiri, they say that تَفَرُّقُ بِالدِّينِ is making sex of the earth. Sex, firqas theory, but another meaning is an aqimu deen wa la tatafarraqu bihi. Don't do any tafarruq in deen. Take it as a package. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qulu bisilmi kaffa. There is no pick and choose. There is no pick and choose that nija nija hafa or kawa kawa. Yes, then what is sweet in deen, just eat it. Like is, if people say, then why we like halwa because when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yuhibbul huluw wal asr. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in love with halwa and with asr. Because both are sweet. But the same Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was in love with swords for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was in love with the battle for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because then we are in Munkar and in the Muqtada of Deen as well. كُلْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ. I'm not sending you to jihad, look at me. Yes. You take it light. I'm only telling you. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, أَنْ أَقِيمُ الدِّينُ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا بِهِ. So now, إِقَامَةُ الدِّينُ. One meaning is to establish it. The second one is to implement it. The third one is keep this in straight form and straight condition. Don't bend it. Don't make it crooked, because his deen is very straight. That's why this Sirat is called Sirat al-Mustaqim. Ihdina. Say, As-Sirat al-Mustaqim. Wa innaka latad'uhum ila Sirat al-Mustaqim. Yasin wal-Qur'an al-Hakim. Innaka min al-Mursaleen ala Sirat al-Mustaqim. Inna Ibrahima. كان أمة قانتا لله اجتباه وهداه إلى صراط المستقيم. Every real deal is صراط المستقيم. And look at me, my dear respected brothers. As you know, the da'wah, what? Da'wah, it has three kinds. One is the da'wah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One is the da'wah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And one is the أمه. So what is the dawah of Allah? والله يدعو إلى دار السلام. There is a very big place which is called Dar al-Salam. The house of peace or the home of peace means the Jannah. So all of us, we have been invited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Dar al-Salam for lunch or for dinner. But ever, no forever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that you are my guest, come to Dar al-Salam and enjoy your life there. What's wrong with you that you are not proceeding towards? وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُوا إِلَىٰ دَارِ السَّلَامِ. So now, if you receive a card, invitation card, that a marriage is taking place, in such like marriage hall, or in such like hotel, or whatever the place is, yes. So now what you receive, but number two, you are in need of a direction, that which way to go to that place. So you have to ask who? The Google. You have to ask Sheikh Google. You have to ask who? Sheikh Google. Yes, to guide and to lead you toward that place. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, to come to Dar al-Salam, I have sent you my messenger. وَإِنَّكَ لَتَدْعُوهُمْ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are calling them towards that freeway, or that motorway, or that route, which will take them to Dar al-Salam. Now, Siratul Mustaqim, what is that? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called to what? What is that? We are invoking Allah time and again in all of our prayers, in Siratul Mustaqim. Hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was asked by Sahabi, Mas Siratul Mustaqim? Waqeel al-Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Mustaqim. What is the Sirat al-Mustaqim we are invoking Allah for? We are asking for. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Huwa ma ana alayhi wa ashabi. Huwa ma ana alayhi wa ashabi. That is the way of life I adopted and my sahaba adopted. A delegation came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِلَىٰ مَتَدْهُ يَا رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. What's your mission? What's your call to war? What you are calling to war? إِلَىٰ مَتَدْهُ يَا رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, هَذِهِ سَبِيلِ أَدْعُوا إِلَىٰ اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي فَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. That I am calling you to this part of mine. To Sirat al-Mustaqim, I am satisfied with it. Woman ittaba'ani, my sahaba are satisfied with it as well. So now look, when you are satisfied with deen, so then you are ready for any and every type of sacrifice for deen. Let me give you an example. Look at it. Give me an example. Iman and aqidah, that is the practice of brain or practice of heart. So, well, you are right. Don't hesitate. Even though if the answer is wrong, hesitate not. Because you are a caller. If you will hesitate and the concept is wrong, so you will be connected to that wrong forever. But when you express, so if it is wrong, some elder monarch, Gurdwara Sahib, our Sheikh, another alim, he will correct you. I'm just another honor. One honor. I'm just another honor. وَنَدَا نَدْ كَنَا دَانَتْ تَرْجَحْنِ مُرَكَّبْ عَبَدُ الدَّهَرْ بِمَانَتْ وَنَسْ كَنَا دَانَتْ وَبِدَا نَدْ كَنَا دَانَتْ اُنِيسْ خَرَيْ خَيْفْ بَمَنْزِلْ بِرَسَانَتْ. Sani Baba said, عَقَسْ كَنَا دَانَتْ وَنَدَا نَدْ كَنَا دَانَتْ. The one who does not know, and he does not know that he does not know. إِنَّ مِنَ الْغَيْمِ أَنْ تَقُولَ لِمَا لَا تَعْلَ. Hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, this is also a good knowledge, or a type of knowledge. When you say regarding something which you do not know, then I don't know. Imam Malik, rahmatullahi alayhi, great personality, a smart person. Same. Great personality, Hibul Madina, rahmatullahi alayhi. So Imam Malik, he was like this. He was asked about 40 issues. 40 questions, you can say, 40 استفتاءات. How many? 40 استفتاءات. فأجاب في أربعة وسكت عن ستة وثلاثين. answered at the moment only four questions. And he kept quiet in 36, and he told the people, tomorrow I will come. Now, our case is, if somebody will ask me, I don't want to put myself down, I will make a mess and give him every type of squad. So bro, you are not afraid of what you are doing. You are putting people on the wrong road. You are misleading them, giving them wrong fatwas. The Sahaba, regarding fatwa, they were very curious. They were very careful. It is said that Ibn Abbas, great scholar of Quran and Sunnah, smart. Great scholar, he got the reason to proceed. Somebody asked him, Abdullah, Raziyallahu ta'ala anhu, how you became that much bigger a alim or greater a alim? So he said that, I don't claim it, but you said it. I don't claim it, but you said it. So a few things that is beyond this ilm and knowledge of mine. Number one, firstly, the du'a of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My mother, you know the name of the mother of Abdullah ibn Abbas? Anybody who knows? Sayyidah Umm al-Fadl, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. She was the wife of Abbas, the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was impressed by two ladies too much. He was giving them the respect of a mom. Number one, Fatima bint Asad, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. She was the mother of Sayyidina Ali, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. In Urdu language, we call it Chachi. What? Chachi. The wife of Chacha, or Kaka, wife of Kaka. Yes? So she was the Chachi. What? I mean, I mentioned the name. Fatima bint Asad. No, there are so many ladies by the name of Fatima. Fatima bint Asad, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. And when she passed away, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sitting at the grave of Fatima bint Asad, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. And he said that this noble lady has given me the love of her mom, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. And the second one, Sayyida Umm al-Fadl, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. The house of Abbas was close to the house of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the neighborhood of Safa. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sometime when he was going out of Baitullah Sharif, so he used to go straight to the house of Umm al-Fadl, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. And Umm al-Fadl, most of the time she was waiting for a specific time that Prophet will come, inshallah. So my dear respected brothers, Ibn Abbas said, radiyallahu ta'ala, my mother told me that you were born. So after a few days, I took you to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I said, Ya Rasulullah, ud'u li akhika. He was first cousin of the Prophet, ud'u li akhika. Ya Rasulullah, make a dua for your brother. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made a dua. Allahumma faqqihu fi deen wa allimhu al-Quran. Wa la subhanahu wa ta'ala give him faqahat fi deen and teach him Quran. That's number one. Number two, Ibn Abbas said, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, I was eager regarding knowledge of Quran and Sunnah. So my aunt, the sister of my mom, her name is, anybody who knows? Sayyida Maymuna, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. Umm al-Mu'mineen Sayyida Maymuna, she was the sister of Umm al-Fadl, and she was the khala of Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiyallahu ta'ala anha, and also the khala of Khalid ibn Walid, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. Got it? And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he married Maymuna, that was an affection for Khalid ibn Walid to accept Islam. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Sayyida Maymuna, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how many wives, our Ummahat al-Mu'mineen, how many they were in number? Eleven. Yes. And the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away. So 10 of them, they were alive. Because as long as Sayyida Khadija was alive, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never married another woman. When Khadija passed away, radiyallahu ta'ala anha, then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam married a few women. And that was not based on desires. The motive behind these many marriages of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was Islam. Because Arabian culture, that was tribal culture. And when you are related to a tribe,
So they are supposed to support and help you.
They believe in your message or not, but because of their connection, they are your in-laws, so they will give you your support.
So my dear respected brothers in Islam, so anyhow, Sayyidina Maimuna, from Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he used to put a number in turn to spend the night or day in the house of any one of his wives.
So Ibn Abbas said, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, I used to mark the calendar.
I used what?
To mark the calendar that what day and night Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam will be in the house of my father.
Maimuna, radiallahu ta'ala anhu.
So on day, very day and night, I used to go to the house of my khala to spend more time with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam,
to observe, to watch what he is doing.
Because every single action and practice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is so sacred.
Say, because you find in the hadith that what is hadith and what is sunnah, what is khabar and what is asar,
your ulama and your teachers, they are the difference and the distinction, and they say that all these terms are interchangeable as well.
Sometimes we are making tabir of khabar from hadith, tabir of asar from hadith,
yes, and tabir of hadith from sunnah, or sunnah from hadith. But for academic purpose, they define it separately. But commonly, when they define hadith, so they say, Qawlul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, aw fi'luhu aw taqriruhu.
Then the speech of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the word of the Prophet.
Number two, the action of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
or taqriruhu, are the sanction of the Prophet. What?
The sanction. And what is sanction?
Because sanction is punishment also.
There is taqdis also.
So here, that sanction is the meaning of taqrir.
And taqrir means tasbih.
Taqrir means what?
Tasbih. In English, you can translate it approval.
Approval, but not express the approval.
Silent approval.
What?
Silent approval. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw someone, he was doing something or saying something, and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kept quiet. It means that that thing is allowed and permissible to the again.
Otherwise, a Prophet will never keep quiet on something which is wrong.
Right away he will say this is wrong.
Don't say it or don't do it.
Yes, Taiz.
You are reciting Quran. You have memorized Quran. You are learning Tafsir as well. In Surah Al-Kahf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is relating the story of Musa alayhi salatu wa salam with Abdan min Ibadina.
Who was that Abdan min Ibadina?
So mostly the Mufassirin said, mostly the Mufassirin said that it was Hazir alayhi salatu wa salam.
But anyhow,
we have nothing to do with the man.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala titled him as Abd
bin Ibadina.
So that was someone very near to Allah
subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, he was giving his sermon. He was giving his bayan. And bayan was very attractive, very comprehensive, touching the heart.
So somebody asked Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, then do you know anybody who is much more bigger a alim than you?
Are much more greater than Alim than you.
So Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, he said, it was reality.
It was fact.
But no.
Because a messenger of the time is the utmost greatest Alim of the time.
Is it so or not?
Say no.
Yes.
So he said, no.
But this time of expression, Hassanatul Abrani Sayyidatul Mutarrani,
such like great is not like to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him a message that you have to do your abdam in ibadina.
He knows what you do not know.
So the story is very long.
Let's make it short.
Musa alayhi salatu wa salam came here.
Qala hal attabi'uka ala an tu'allimani mimma 'allamta rushda.
Can I follow you to teach me? Because this is madrasa.
And these are just the adab and the protocol of madrasa.
Of the adab of protocol of ta'lim and ta'allum.
When you are going to study under a alim,
yes, you see.
Yes, inshallah.
To study under a alim, so you have to ask, then can I attend your class?
Yes, so when he will allow you, you will become a student of the class
concerned. Al attabi'uka ala an tu'allimani mimma 'allamta rushda.
So Hazir alayhi salatu wa salam said,
you will not be able to show patience.
You will be making
created now objections even. You're making reservation to what I am doing. So he said, Sattajid me, insha'Allah, sabira, wala asilaka amra. That if Allah wills, so you will see me that I am a patient man, I will not get any objection. And he said, insha'Allah, not to be blamed at the time. Because somebody said to his wife, we're not going to call upon insha'Allah, but I say, I'm done. ومن وصل بكلام انشاءالله فتركنا ومن وصل بكلام انشاءالله فتركنا فابني المسجد رب الله سبحانه وتعالى بالله keep quiet if something is going other way around that's what موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام said then no so anyhow you are students of Quran and Sunnah may الله سبحانه وتعالى bless you so قل حبيث بالذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون announce O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم that those who know and those who do not know, they are equal. So now the answer is no. Yes, well, exactly the answer as well. That they are not equal. But in the mind, the director, Ulul Albab, only Ulul Albab, and God is the core of Allah. Look eventually the core of Allah, not Hazrat, like almond and walnuts. It has a shell, air is on here, if you have not broken it, you cannot eat it. You have to break it. So look in when you will break the other and you will bring forth and bring out the gold that you can do it. Innama yatadakkaru ulul albab. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you. I don't want to disturb your class because you are going to class. I don't receive the knowledge that is much more important than anything else. Wa akhir ta'wana. Alhamdulillah wa ta'ala. 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 اللهم ارضى منا بكرائمنا اللهم اكرمنا من كرائم ما نسينا واعطنا منه ما جهلنا واذكرنا تلاوته اناء الليل واناء النهار اللهم ربنا اعنا ولا تهنا واخذنا ولا تنزع علينا اللهم ربنا اهدنا واهدنا واجعلنا هداة المهديين دعاة الى سبيل الامات الدين اللهم ربنا اجعلنا من الراشدين الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون احسنه وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد واله واصحابه اجمعين برحمتك.